you. As you heard, exciting times are happening in Mozambique, and I'm excited about sharing it with you. I'm just trying to get this thing working here. Almost a minute. Okay. Yeah, so wonderful things are happening. Julie, I think, is looking for my Bible. I had it out there somewhere. I don't know where it is now, but it's here somewhere, I promise. I brought it. But okay, God is so good, huh?
Amen.
I really enjoyed the worship today. I just felt like, God was just opening up the heavens. I felt like I saw like Jacob's ladder. You know, and the heavens opened, and the angels ascending and descending upon us, and I just really felt like there was that we were under an open heavens tonight, and so I just, you know, what it did was it reminded me of back in Africa, being over there again. You know, this last time that I was in Africa was probably one of the most wonderful times so far. I mean, just amazing. The open heavens, the presence of the Lord. And, it was incredible. And like she said, you know, I really thank you guys for your prayers. And I really am feeling the impact of prayer here, you know. And so I'm excited to come and see that God is doing much the same right here in this place. And so, yeah. Well, let's get started with a quick prayer. How's that sound to you? And Ms. Malachowski and Julie, you may have to put that thing back on that. If your arm's probably going to get tired. I know mine did. You could maybe put it back on that ledge up there. So, feel sorry for you. Hold that here. But okay. Just Lord, we just come before you. We thank you, Father, for your presence. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for all that you are, all that you've done, all that you continue to do. Lord, we thank you for answered prayer, God. We magnify your name, the name of Jesus above every name. And his name, every knee must bow, every tongue must confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Lord, so we just take dominion, Lord, here and now in this place in our lives, God. Lord, let your kingdom come. Let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven, here in every heart, every life, Lord, in this church, Lord, in Mozambique, God, we take dominion. Lord, you said that we're on wherever at the sole of our foot treads, Lord, you have given it to us. Lord, that is a promise, Lord. And we know that the promises of God, all of them are yes and amen in Christ Jesus. Lord, and we thank you, Lord, for the answered prayer, Lord, in Africa. We thank you for the answered prayer here. We thank you for the open heavens, Lord. We ask God tonight that you would come, that you would take our ears, Lord, that you would take our eyes, Lord, that we would see, Lord, and hear, God, what the Spirit is saying to the churches, Lord. Revive us, O Lord. God, we ask, Lord, if there's anything within us that is displeasing in your sight, Lord, that you would forgive us for it, Lord, and reveal it to us, Lord, that we might turn, repent, and go in the right direction, Lord, after your heart. Lord, we want to be men, women, and children after the heart of God, Lord, even as David was, Lord. So, Lord, we give you our lives. We give you our time, Lord. I give you my time, my life, Lord. Live in me, God. Live in us, Lord. Let our ears be open and our eyes be open to hear and see, Lord, tonight. We give you thanks, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Wow, man, I feel his presence. I feel his presence. You know, the last time in Mozambique, you know, we just started doing what we always do. You know, I would get up at 3, 4 in the morning, seek his face, read, worship, pray, write down everything he's saying. And just them, they would come, my disciples, my sons in the faith would come at 6:30, 7 o'clock, and we would start seeking God, worshiping, praying, giving thanks to God, and then discipling, just sharing what God was saying, you know, and what God was trying to do in our hearts. And I just, you know, as I've said many times before in the past, I felt like God was saying that Michael, I didn't bring you here to build buildings of stone or wood or anything like that. I didn't bring you here to build big programs. I brought you here to build my house in your heart, and then to through you to build my house in the hearts of those around you. You know, and I felt like the Lord was saying, don't you start any day doing any other kind of work. Your work is to believe. Their work is to believe, you know, and seek my face. You know, if we will seek him diligently, we will find him. Yeah. You understand that? Yeah. Do you believe that? Yeah. He is here with us tonight, right now, every day of our lives. He's here with you. Yeah. You know, the problem that most of mankind has is the same problem that Zacchaeus had. You know, when Jesus was passing by, Zacchaeus, he was a tax collector. He was a short man, you know, so he couldn't see because of all the people, all the commotion, around him. You know, like Jesus, you know, like it's written in the scripture, you know, the cares of this life, the deceitfulness of riches entered in and choked out the word of God, the fruitfulness of it. And that's what humanity and all the pursuits of men will do to your faith, to your life. You know, they will choke it out. They will blind you to the reality of realities. Amen. How many of you know that what you're living in right now, though in ways it's reality, yet there's a greater reality. There's a greater calling. This earth is not our home. We are strangers, sojourners, pilgrims in this place, in this life, you know. We are citizens of heaven, members of the household of God. You know, our place is seated with Christ Jesus in heavenly places. That is who we are. And we've got to be like Zacchaeus, who, you know, when he saw that he was too short to see Jesus because of all the people, he said, man, I'm going to find a way. I'm going to go to this tree. He started climbing the tree. I've got to see Jesus. Nothing is going to keep me from seeing Jesus. And that's exactly what we've got to do. We've got to say, I've got to have him. I can't live without him. I'm not going to be cheated. I'm not going to let humanity and the pursuits of this life, the deceitfulness of riches, choke out his life in me. I'm going to go after him. I'm going to find the tree. I'm going to climb. I'm going to see him. You see? And when Jesus perceived that faith in Zacchaeus, that even though humanity blocked him and the cares of this life blocked him from seeing, Jesus perceived that he said, no way. I've got to see him. He's come walking by me. I don't want to let this life pass me by without seeing him. And that, my friends, is God's call on our life today, to be like Zacchaeus. Amen. There's a reality that exists that's greater. It's not all about you. It's not all about America. It's not all about this world. You know, there's a kingdom. The kingdom of God, is here. It's now. It's amongst us. Yes. You know, it's with you. It's within you. Jesus said, the kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. You see? And we're going to get into the message here in a minute. This I didn't even write this down. And in fact, while I was out there earlier, I had been preparing another message, but and I spent much time on it. But when I was out there, I felt the Lord redirect me to this message on faith. And then Pastor spoke the word faith here a minute ago, and I was, yes, It's the Lord, you know? So we're just going to go into this. And gosh, the last time, does anybody have any water? Like, I know I'm going to need some water. Okay, so the last time I was there, we sought the Lord with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength. We drew close to Him, and He drew close to us. And I tell you that God heard our prayers, God heard our cries, God saw our hungry hearts. He saw that with diligence we had sought Him. And I tell you, God rained down upon us the peace, the joy, the righteousness of the Lord. I felt, and we felt, overwhelming peace, overwhelming joy. His presence was with us. I felt so many times, every day, I just felt like every step was guarded, guided, protected. I felt like we were under the shadow of the Almighty. I felt like we were in His embrace, and that nothing could harm us, nothing could touch us. I felt that like a warm blanket just all over us, all over me, all over us. We felt it, His presence, His anointing. He breaks the yoke, sets the captives free. He caught us up into the heavenly places in our spirit man. We began to see who we were in Christ and who He was in us, who He is in us. And so I was excited when I came in here tonight and was sensing the same things. Thank you so much, brother. You will not lose your reward. Oh, God. Thank you for water. Give me the wisdom to open it. These are interesting. Okay. Now, Lord, don't let us spill. Where's my Bible? You didn't find my Bible? I wonder, I think I put it in my coat. Is Julie here? It might be in the pocket of my coat, which I hung up right over there. Anyway, well, we'll do it with or without the Bible. I got it right here anyway, most of it. But I always like to have my Bible just in case the Lord says, son, over here. Thank you, Brother John. You are a lifesaver. Okay, so let's turn to Luke.